Hello everyone, happy evening, a very good evening. So welcome to our today's YouTube session in a series called C3 with N3, that is cheat codes and concepts with Dr. Nikita Nanwani Nathani. So guys, before I proceed with the session, could you give me a quick nod whether the audio visual is good? Thank you, Kirti. Thank you so much for the quick nod. So in our today's session, we are going to see easy mnemonics to remember the various named cardiac murmurs. So we have had quite a few sessions on cardiac murmurs in our last week's cardiology integrated sessions. Those were the free live classes. If you have missed those, you can still watch those on the Unacademy app with as recorded sessions. So everything is very, very high yield in those sessions. So if you have missed those sessions, make sure you watch those sessions. And for activating your free live classes, if you are asked a password or a code, you can use my code DrNikita-YT for watching those sessions. So named cardiac murmurs, there are around 7 to 8. We will quickly revise them. This is really short session, like approximately 25 minutes. Then we are meeting again after the session at 5 p.m. Immediately after the session, we are going to meet on Unacademy app for a free live class, a special class on PYQs. PYQs, so Throwback Thursday, today being a Thursday, I've started with Throwback Thursday session every Thursday where we will be discussing the PYQs. And in our today's session, we are going to discuss some PYQs from biochemistry, from your exam NEET PG 2018 ke some questions we would be seeing, right? So let's meet at 5 p.m. after this session again. And let's start with our today's session. Before that, I hope you guys are all aware of the plus subscription on Unacademy, which is actually like Netflix. You can get access to all the courses going on of all the educators with one subscription. You have daily live classes from the comfort of your home. You have live tests and quizzes. You have structured courses. Now all the courses are very much structured and organized, and as I said, it's unlimited access. One subscription gives you access to everything, right? Apart from that, we have iconic subscription as well, which is Unacademy plus Prep Ladder together, so the best of live and recorded platform. And we have daily free test series on Unacademy NEET PG, and at 8 p.m 8:30, 9 p.m and I personally conduct the sessions at 10 a.m and 10 p.m every day based on the daily targets in the revision timetable that I have given you on the Telegram group. So we have a pre-test every morning 10 a.m and at the night, once you finish that daily target, at 10 p.m we have the post-test, right? We are also coming up with something called as Revisathon. This is very, very new that has come up. So Revisathon is your scholarship test series. It is going to be there every Sunday, 5 to 6 p.m. A 1 hour test. It's going to be 45 questions, subject wise test. So the good news is that the top 3 students will get 100% scholarship on the Unacademy Plus subscription, 6 months, 12 months and so on. The next 10 will get 75%. And the next 50 will get 50% scholarship. So basically, if you are in top 63, you get your scholarships on the plus subscription, I think, which is the best thing that can happen. So 21st of February is your first revisathon, which is coming. Even I am not sure what subject do we have on 21st. Maybe we can check that on the app and I can update you as well once I confirm with the team what subject wise test do we have on coming 21st of February. All right. Previous throwback PDF, not all the PDFs are available. I've taken Throwback Thursdays on YouTube. So some PDFs are available, some are not available. If you want, I'll share whatever PDFs you want. I can share with you on the group. All right. And so to meet again at 5 p.m., you guys need to download the Unacademy app. And to access the free class, you need to use the code DrNikita-YT. Even when you are subscribing, you can use my code DrNikita-YT for additional discount. The longer the subscription you take, the more cost effective it is. So the undergraduate students, you should aim for a longer subscription because that is what is more cost effective, right? And FMD students, we have the focus batch starting 22nd of February. By 29th May, your entire syllabus will be covered well before your exam, which is on 18th of June. So please make a note of this, the FMD students. This is a plus course which is coming up, right? Now, I am going to ask you questions and you need to answer these questions on named cardiac murmurs. The first one, what is that named cardiac murmur? Which is a mid-diastolic, low-pitched, rumbling murmur which is seen in aortic regurgitation. Alright, so this is your first question that we have, which is that mid-diastolic low-pitched murmur. Absolutely right. It is your Austin-Flint murmur. Now, if I would have not given you that this is an aortic regurgitation, when we look at the term mid-diastolic low-pitched rumbling murmur, what do we think of? We think of mitral stenosis. So this Austin-Flint murmur is similar to your mitral stenosis. We have discussed in our session, aortic regurgitation mein, jab aapka regurgitant jet aata hai, that causes the early closure of mitral valve, which is like mitral stenosis, and that causes the Austin-Flint murmur. So remember that Austin-Flint is seen in aortic regurgitation. Okay, Austin-Flint, A for A, Austin-Flint is seen in aortic regurgitation. The next one, which is that short mid-diastolic murmur caused by active rheumatic carditis with mitral valve inflammation, which is that named murmur that we have. Again, a short mid-diastolic murmur, so similar to mitral stenosis, but caused by active rheumatic carditis. What murmur is that? Very good. So this is your Carey-Coombs murmur. So Carey-Coombs murmur is seen in your acute rheumatic carditis when you have inflammation of the mitral valve, the thickened mitral valve ka leaflets, you know, you have the thickening of the mitral valve leaflets, so that becomes like mitral stenosis. So we see the Carey-Coombs murmur. The mnemonic to remember, Carey-Coombs is A-R-E. That is your acute rheumatic fever, acute rheumatic carditis. Acute rheumatic fever mein jo carditis hoga, in that we see the Carey-Coombs murmur. It is seen in diastole. It is your mid-diastolic murmur. But there is no presystolic accentuation like mitral stenosis. In mitral stenosis, you have the presystolic accentuation. Okay, so this is Carey-Coombs murmur. Going to the next one. Which is that early diastolic murmur, early diastolic similar to aortic regurgitation, but it has an additional presystolic accentuation and it is associated with severe stenosis of the left anterior descending coronary artery. What is that murmur? So this is something which is uncommon named murmur. Austin-Flint we know, Carey-Coombs we know, which is this murmur which is seen when you have stenosis of the left anterior descending coronary artery. So remember, this is called as your, you have Doc's murmur. Okay, that is your Doc's murmur. How do we remember this? If you remember in your cardiac anatomy sessions, again in cardiology sessions that we discussed recently, no, this is not Graham Steel, this is Doc's murmur. LAD, remember D, LAD se humne ek cheez already we had remembered. For D, what is the branch coming from LAD? It is your diagonal artery. It is your diagonal artery. The other D, remember the murmur. In LAD stenosis, we see the Doc's murmur. Can you tell me in ECG session, we have discussed that, which is that syndrome which you see in critical stenosis of proximal LAD. What syndrome is that? In ECG session, we have discussed. What is that syndrome? Absolutely, that is your Valence syndrome. That is your Valence syndrome. And what does it show in ECG? Again, please watch the ECG sessions. you have inverted T wave or you have biphasic T wave, right? You have inverted T wave or biphasic T wave, all right? Let's go to the next one. So this is your Dock's murmur. Remember D4D, it is seen in LAD stenosis. It is associated with LAD stenosis. Now, next one, which is the long rumbling continuous, basically machinery murmur seen in patent ductus arteriosus? Which is the machinery murmur seen in patent ductus arteriosus? So many of us know this absolutely. That is your Gibson or Gibson's murmur. So that is your continuous murmur. You see in systole also, you see in diastole also. Because it is seen in patent ductus arteriosus, that you have a connection between the aorta and the pulmonary artery. The flow is going to be continuous because the pressure difference is there in systole also, in diastole also. So we see a machinery continuous murmur, Gibson murmur. So remember that Gibson, remember like that, Gibson, a mechanic named Gibson. Okay, so mechanic is basically your machine, that is your machinery murmur in PDA, patent ductus arteriosus. So Gibson is your mechanic, that is your machinery murmur. Next one. Which is the soft blowing decrescendo early diastolic murmur associated with pulmonary incompetence, which is caused by pulmonary hypertension? So when we have pulmonary hypertension, the pulmonary artery enlarges. So the valve is not able to close properly now, right? So that is why we have pulmonary incompetence, that is pulmonary regurgitation in pulmonary arterial hypertension or pulmonary hypertension. Which is that murmur? That is your Graham-Steele murmur. That is your Graham-Steele murmur. How did we remember this? Pulmonary hypertension, remember phone, pulmonary hypertension. Alexander Graham Bell, he invented the phone, that is pulmonary hypertension. So Graham is phone, that is pulmonary hypertension. Okay, so Graham-Steele murmur is pulmonary hypertension. Dilated artery, you get pulmonary regurgitation, and pulmonary regurgitation has a early diastolic murmur. Okay, it has a decrescendo early diastolic murmur. So that is your Graham-Steele murmur. Next one, which is the, this is very interesting, again an uncommon one, mid diastolic apical murmur seen in complete heart block. What is that named murmur that we see in complete heart block? The mid-diastolic apical murmur. Anyone? In complete heart block, the named murmur that we see is your Reitan's murmur. Okay, there's something called as Reitan's murmur. Now, this is a new one to remember. Now, how do we remember is when we have complete heart block, remember like it is the end of life. It is the end of life. End helps you to remember it is right end. Okay. So end helps you to remember that it is right end's murmur, complete heart block. In a JVP session, we have discussed what do we see in complete heart block. What do we see in JVP in complete heart block? Your Cannon A waves. You have Cannon A waves. Very good, Rafina. That is your right end murmur. JVP mein we see the Cannon A waves, huge A waves, irregular huge A waves, right? So this is your right end murmur. Then next one, an easy one, benign flow murmur across the aortic valve from high cardiac output and or increased contractility. So when you have your high cardiac output, so that causes your flow murmur, that is a functional murmur across the aortic valve. Either it could be due to high cardiac output state or due to increased contractility. So you have more blood going out. So that is your flow murmur. It's a benign flow murmur. And this is commonly seen in pediatric population, commonly seen in children. That is your Still's murmur, right? That is your Still's murmur, which is also called as innocent or functional murmur. How do you differentiate it from your other murmurs? Because the patient will not have any symptoms, no dyspnea, nothing, no cardiovascular symptoms. There is no abnormal finding on cardiovascular examination. So you do not need any treatment when a patient has a Still's murmur. Since it is due to increased cardiac output, So what kind of murmur is this? It is your like a ejection systolic murmur. It is a systolic murmur which you hear when the blood goes from the left ventricle to the aorta during the systole. So it is like a systolic murmur. So that is your Still's murmur or innocent functional murmur. So how do we remember this is Still's murmur is a functional murmur. So remember that there is no pathology. There is no pathology in the heart. Still we see this still murmur, okay? So there is no pathology, still we hear this murmur, that is your Still's murmur. So no pathology, still a murmur is your Still's murmur, that is innocent or functional murmur, okay? Innocent or functional murmur. Next one, what is that named murmur that we see due to air in RV following the cardiac catheterization? So if you have venous embolism, so air coming into your right side of heart, or you do cardiac catheterization, so air comes in the right ventricle. So the murmur that we see due to air in RV following the cardiac catheterization is air, air matlab wind, okay, air matlab wind. So that is your windmill murmur or your mill wheel murmur. From windmill, air se yaad rakhna wind, you have windmill, so you have mill wheel murmur. So remember, that is your mill wheel murmur. So how do we remember? Mill is your windmill, so that means it is air in the right ventricle or the right side of the heart, basically due to venous embolism or after cardiac catheterization. So mill wheel murmur, mill wheel, mill is windmill, so that is air. Air ki wajah se, that is your mill wheel murmur. Next one, which is the loud holosystolic murmur of ventricular septal defect? We know that when you have your ventricular septal defect, the blood goes from ventricle LV to RV throughout the systole. So we get a loud holosystolic murmur. What did we discuss? When do you get a loud murmur? When the VSD is small or when the VSD is large? When will you hear a louder murmur? If your defect is small or if your defect is large? When the defect is large, the blood will go very easily without creating any turbulence. When the defect is small, there will be a turbulence. So when you have your small VSD, it is going to be a loud holosystolic murmur, right? Now what murmur is it called as? Anyone, what is that named murmur for this? That is your Rogers murmur, okay? That is your Rogers murmur or Bruey D. Roger. That is basically your Rogers murmur. So you can see that it is your pansystolic between S1 and S2. We know between S1 and S2 you have systole. So this is your pansystolic murmur, okay? This is your pansystolic murmur that we hear in VSD, ventricular septal defect. We hear a Rogers murmur, no mnemonic for this. Just remember, ek unusual wala aaya, so that is your Rogers murmur. So let us quickly revise all the murmurs that we saw just now. Okay, let us quickly revise the named murmurs. Okay. So the first one, what is the murmur? What is the murmur? So Kirti Varman, MR has its radiation to axilla. Your mitral regurgitation murmur radiates to axilla. That is one feature to differentiate your VSD from MR. And mitral regurgitation best heard at the apex. VSD is best heard at the ERBS point. We have discussed all of this in the cardiac murmur session in the Unacademy app. You can watch those recorded sessions as well. ठीक है, quickly revise करते हैं, okay? So where do you see your Carey Coombs murmur? Where do you see the Carey Coombs murmur? Where do we see the Carey Coombs? ARE. It is your acute rheumatic fever. Okay, it is your acute rheumatic fever, acute rheumatic carditis. Next one, where do we see your Austin Flint murmur? Where do we see Austin Flint murmur? Austin Flint. A for A, it is aortic regurgitation. Remember, it is aortic regurgitation. What do you have in aortic stenosis? Remember the session we had discussed in the last YouTube session also. What phenomenon do we see in aortic stenosis? That is your Gallawarden phenomenon. We see Gallawarden phenomenon in aortic stenosis. नेक्स्ट वन ऑस्टिन फ्लिंट हो गया. उसके बाद वेयर डू वी सी डॉक्स मर्मर, इन विच कंडीशन डू वी सी डॉक्स मर्मर. डी इज डी, इट इज योर एल ए डी स्टेनोसिस, इट इज योर एल ए डी स्टेनोसिस. Then you have your right end murmur. During the end of the life, complete heart block. So in your complete heart block, we see the right end murmur. What is your mill wheel murmur? What is your mill wheel murmur? Mill is your windmill. Wind matlab air. So when you have air in the right ventricle, due to venous embolism or cardiac catheterization, that is your mill wheel murmur. Okay, that is your mill wheel murmur. What is a Still's murmur? What is a Still's murmur? Still, there is no pathology. Still, we see this murmur. So, it is a functional murmur. It is not a pathologic or anatomic murmur. It is a functional innocent murmur due to high cardiac output commonly seen in children. This is a systolic murmur. This is a systolic murmur. Then next we have, what is the murmur that we see in ventricular septal defect, the pan-systolic murmur? That is your Rogers murmur. That is your Rogers murmur. Okay, that is your Rogers murmur. Anything else you remember? Your Graham-Steele murmur, right? The next one is your Graham-Steele murmur. Where do we see the Graham-Steele? Graham Bell phone. Graham, Alexander Graham Bell invented phone. PH phone ka, that is your pulmonary hypertension. In pulmonary hypertension, we get pulmonary regurgitation. So this is your early diastolic murmur, right? This is your early diastolic murmur. That is your Graham-Steele murmur. Okay, that is your Graham-Steele murmur. So I think we have covered the majority of the murmurs, right? We have covered the majority of the murmurs. The named murmurs, these are very, very important, and we have seen all the mnemonics to remember this. Gibson murmur, very good, T. Patel. So let's add the Gibson murmur. Gibson, remember, Gibson is a mechanic, so machinery murmur, it is a machinery murmur in PDA, continuous machinery murmur in PDA, that is your Gibson's murmur. Okay, so these are the 9 named murmurs that we have discussed. That was a quick review of all the named murmurs. I hope you remember all these murmurs. Okay, I hope you remember all these murmurs with the mnemonics. So that's all for this session, guys. I am seeing you again at 5 p.m. in next half an hour at the Unacademy app in a free live class, which is going to be on PYQs, first year subjects. I am targeting today biochemistry. We will quickly revise the NEET PG 2018 questions of biochemistry. So we will see the concepts, we will see some mnemonics to make biochemistry fun. I know many of us don't like biochemistry, but actually it's very, very interesting subject. That is what I feel. So let's meet again in half an hour at 5 p.m. to join the free class. If you are asked for the activation code, you can use the code DrNikita-YT. Okay. So I'll see you at 5 p.m. Till then, goodbye. Take care. Keep studying, keep revising, and keep winning. Thank you.